Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Welcome back. So in the previous video, we have covered RDT 1.0 and 2.0, 2.1 and 2.2. We know the advantage disadvantages of one over other. So in this section, we'll see RDT 3.0. Why we have to use 3.0 and how it works. So as I said in the previous session, I'm using the PPT from the book Computer Networking, the top-down approach, 6th edition, James F. Corozzo, and this video is not for commercial purpose, only to help our students. Anyways, in RDT 3.0, channels with the errors and loss. In RDT 2.0 and 2.1, we assume there is a bit loss, bit error. But here it is a channel with errors and loss. Not only errors, there may be packet loss. Either data packet can be lost or acknowledgement packet can be lost. So we adopted different methods already. Checksum, sequence, acknowledgements, retransmission. All these will be help, but not enough. So what is the solution for this one? Solution for this one is here, sender will use something called as a timer. As soon as the sender transmits the packet, we will start the timer. And if he has not received the acknowledgement, if the packet is lost or if the acknowledgement is delayed, and if timer times out, retransmission will be done. Even though it will result in duplicate, we know how to handle duplicate based on our theory 2.0 and 2.1. So this is the method approach is used in RDT 3.0. So now you see the FSM of RDT 3.0. Let me quickly explain this one. So it is waiting for the packet. As soon as the packet comes, so as soon as the packet comes, what it will do? As soon as the data comes, RDT send event will be called and following actions will be taken. So please remember here, this is the sequence number, this is the data, this is the checksum, and it will send the packet, it will start the timer. It will move from call zero to wait for acknowledgement zero. In the acknowledgement zero, just think it has received the packet, but it is corrupted, or received the acknowledgement, but sequence number is different here. I sent zero and received the acknowledgement for one. No action is taken in this case, and is waiting for timeout. If the timeout occurs, you will resend the packet and start the timer. If he receives the packet not corrupted or acknowledgement is zero, whatever he sent, the packet acknowledgement zero, you'll stop the timer and now you will move from acknowledgement, this one, wait acknowledgement state, wait for acknowledgement state to call, wait for call one. So one more packet from the upper layer. Once again, create the packet with the sequence number one and send it and wait for acknowledgement. And once again, same scenario repeats here. So it will use the sequence number 0101. So it is called as, sometimes it is referred as RDT 3.0 is referred as alternating bit protocol. Sometimes RDT 3 is referred as alternating bit protocol. This is the FSM explanation of RDT 3.0. Now we'll see the action. Action is for either acknowledgement lost or packet lost or duplicate packets. We'll see one by one. First, you can see here, sender send the packet, receiver received the packet, receiver send the acknowledgement, sender send the next packet. Fine, this no loss. Here, packet 1 is lost. Packet 1 is lost. You will wait for the acknowledgement. Packet 1 is lost. So you will not receive acknowledgement. You will wait for the acknowledgement. Resend the packet. Then he has received the acknowledgement. Fine. Proceed with once again. That is the one scenario. No loss with loss of packet. Now, send packet, received acknowledgement, send packet, received acknowledgement, acknowledgement is lost. He will wait for the timer. Timeout. Resend the packet. He will come to know it is a duplicate packet. Receiver will come to know it is a duplicate packet. Why? Because you will see the acknowledgement. Acknowledgement is you will see the sequence number. Sequence number is 1. 1 has already received. He says he will send once again acknowledgement 1. So acknowledgement 1 indicates indication for this person received. Then he will send packet 0, acknowledgement 0. Next. Send the packet, receive the packet, send the packet. Then acknowledgement is on the way, by that time timeout. Acknowledgement is on the way, by that time timeout. He will resend it. And he will detect, receiver will detect it is a duplicate packet. And receiver will send acknowledgement one, saying the duplicate one. Then once again it will repeat, so please go through it. So this is the action of RDT 3.0. Four scenarios, one is no loss, second one is a packet loss, third one is a acknowledgement loss, fourth one is a acknowledgement on the way. It is it got delayed a little bit, but still duplicate packet, it results in duplicate packet. So this is this one. Now performance of RDT 3.0 we have to see. So far we are discussing about stop and wait protocol. What we are doing, what do you mean by stop and wait protocol? Or what is that? One more thing. Alternating bit protocol, stop and wait. This is stop and wait protocol or alternating bit protocol. The other name is there. Automatic repeat request protocol. So here, stop and wait protocol. We are sending one packet and we are waiting for the acknowledgement. So now you will see the performance. We are using 1GB link. We are using 1GB link. And you think 15 millisecond propagation delay from one corner to the other corner of the world, if the machines are one corner, east corner and west corner of the world, 15 millisecond is the propagation delay. 15 millisecond. Then RTT is 30 millisecond. 30 millisecond plus means there will be a buffering delay. That is also included. Now, sender want to send 8000 bit packet. 8000 bit packet means sender wants to send 8000 bit packet. That is 1000 bytes packet. So 1000 bytes you want to send. 1000 bytes means 8000 bit packet. 1 Gbps means 10 to the power 9 bits per second. Now what is the transmission? Transmission time, it takes 8 microsecond. Now sender utilization, so total we know RTT plus this one total 30.08, I told 30 plus transmission time is 0.08, this is 0.027. so utilization is 0.027, and in terms of if you take bandwidth, it comes actually 267, it comes actually 267 kilobits per second. And what is the channel, this one link we are using? 1 Gbps. Out of 1 Gbps, this is the this one we have utilized 267 kilobits per second, one out of 1 Gbps. So you can see this one in the next slide here. See here, SHA-128 protocol, first bit is sent here and first bit is reached here. Here is transmitting the entire packet and the last bit is reached. As soon as the last bit packet receives, you will acknowledgement. So time taken here, this is RTT, RTT plus transmission time, transmission or propagation time plus RTT. So sender utilization you will come to know by this formula. So we observe this one, SHA-128 protocol. We are using only sending the packet and we is waiting for the acknowledgement. So we are wasting the time. Instead of that, we will send the multiple packets. We will not waste for the acknowledgement. Let the acknowledgement comes, we will take into consideration. So depending on that, we will do the retransmission or whatever may be. So that is called as pipelining protocols. So pipelining protocols, this is the advanced version of RDT 3.0, that is called as pipelining, where multiple packets are sent depending on the, there is this limit, multiple packets in the sense there is a limit depending on the sequence number or window size, whatever may be. So there is a limit. So and without waiting for the acknowledgement, as soon as the acknowledgement comes, based on the acknowledgement, the packets are retransmitted or packets are acknowledged properly, something like that. So two types of protocols are there in this case. One is called as go back and n means go back and n means and selective repeat. Go back and transmit all, that is the meaning. Here selective repeat is the other category, only selected packet you retransmit. Here based on the acknowledgement, go back and transmit all the packets. Here only selective repeat packets you transmit, that is the meaning. So in the next session we will see, and what is the advantage of that one? The advantage of that one is pipelining will increase the utilization of the bandwidth, utilization of the channel. So it is found that it will increase the utilization by factors of 3. This is very important from the exam point of view. We have to tell that, see, whatever I explained earlier and this scenario you have to explain. That time it was something like 0.227, now it is 81. 3 times, pipeline will increase the utilization by 3 times, 81. So now we will see the next protocol, that is called as pipeline protocol. Please remember, now pipeline protocol, the earlier we have discussed stop and wait protocol, now onwards we will discuss pipeline protocol. There are two categories, go back and then and selective repeat. So all these things next session. So please watch, keep on watching WashTech channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much.